Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. So, in the last episode, we came aboard the Highwind, and, we had a look around, but I guess there's a few more things we should look out for. First of all, I guess Barret could use a little bit more HP, so... Yeah, I talked to this guy before, so you can save, you use the PHS, and restore HP and MP. So, alright, that's all done. Now somebody told me that this guy will give me some backstory on what's going on here. My hands are full, so I'll excuse myself here. Chew the fat. I guess that means have a conversation. Well, what should I talk about? Want to hear why we rebelled? I was actually wondering where all the crew members came from, so this works out. Working on the Highwind, we spent every day slaving under Heidinger. Still think I'm saying that wrong. Whenever he got yelled at by the president, he'd immediately take it out on the crew. We put up all this time, even when he beat us. I mean, I finally made it on the crew of the famous Highwind, and there's no way I was gonna quit over him. Let's see, must have been a week ago? It was my shift, and we were heading towards the North Cave. Everyone, including the president and Scarlet, got on. And with them, I saw Cid, a legendary pilot. And he was looking around the inside of the ship, looking really, you know, nostalgic. He even talked to us. I couldn't believe it, I was so impressed. He said he was every bit as warm-hearted as we always heard. I guess compared to the guys at Shinra, sure. Cid said that if he had the Highwind, things would be a lot easier. Now, here we are, off to save the planet. It's true. He really overwhelmed me. That's why we decided to help. After the North Cave, we went to Junon, or Junon, I still don't know, and started screaming, "Fire, fire!" In the middle of all the commotion, we stole the ship from Shinra. That's how it happened. Just a minor mutiny against our leaders. But Barret and you were captured by Heidinger. We waited 7 days for a chance to rescue you guys, before we finally could. For a second I thought that said Cloud and was like, what? So thanks to our successful mission, we were able to see you again. Hope you didn't... I didn't bore you with that long story. Man, that was a long story. I guess what I wasn't bored, that was what I wanted to know. Let's see, fly the airship. Oh, so I can just fly it right now if I want to? Alright. Arc left, right, strafe, toggle map. Alright. So things have come to this. When you want to take off, just tell the pilot on the bridge. Oh, okay. So he'll just tell me the controls. I'm pretty sure I could figure it out next time. And, is there anything else I could ask you later? Alright. Yeah, so let's go back to the bridge. He told me to wait in the operations room, but there's no one there except for that save guy. Hey, you gonna meet me in the operations room or what? You wanna know? I didn't dislike him. What, Cloud? I gotta admit, he was a strange dude. Just when you thought he was cool, he'd do something, some fool thing. Then when you thought he was smart, he'd show how stupid he was. Everything about him, from his movements to his speech, were kinda odd. Knowing what I do now, I can see why he was that way. Well, as long as you stay alive, you might just see him again someday. Cheer up. I'll be able to see him someday. Can find out where he is, the Highwind will get us there in no time. What do you got to say, Red? Maybe. Cloud is still stuck deep in the North Crater. The fake Cloud, you mean? Where the ground cracked up and swallowed him up. Buried in the depths of the underground. Deep within the earth. Are you talking about the life stream? The life stream sometimes gushes out from cracks in the ocean floor to the surface. I heard about such a place. Uh-huh. Maybe, just maybe Cloud's... Cloud's what? Appears to be a small island near the life stream. They said the life stream sometimes suddenly gushes out at the southern island. remember hearing about this from Seto when I was a child, but I don't remember much else. Alright. So why would we look for the fake cloud when there's a real cloud? Because if we go and get the fake cloud, what's stopping Sephiroth from just controlling him again? I don't know. Doesn't seem like a very solid plan. Are you just gonna say the same thing? Okay, you just signal when you're ready to fly full speed. Didn't you want me to wait in the operations room or something? Is there something... Maybe I just read it wrong last episode? I'm sorry, but last episode, which I recorded like a week ago or something, I was like totally out of it. Because I was pretty sick and I was just... Yeah, I had no idea what was going on. I was like, yeah, we're on a boat now. No, it's not a boat, it's an airboat. I don't know. Anyways, I guess we can just take off. Alright. Pilot training level 4. Ah, are we going? Yeah, we're going. Pilot training, we're off. Okay. Alright. Uh-huh. Oh, that's... Oh, okay. Yeah, I got the hang of it already. Huh, I wonder if we can go back to Midgar. Man, I can see the meteor looming in the distance. So, yeah. Where are we going? Is this like most games with an overworld where if we go to the very bottom it will like loop around? I'm pretty sure I did that once. Like in the I even forgot what the ship was called, the helicopter-ish thing. So if I keep going this way, yeah, I come out the top. Alright, so there's an island near the life stream. The life stream is somewhere up here, so... Whoa, okay. What was that? Came buzzing past here like a powerhouse. Alright, we're not going that way. You know what, let's see- oh. Hello there. Can I... Oh, okay, yeah, I just pressed B, but it, yeah, okay. Let's see what's in here. Have we been in here before? I think this is a new area. Hey there, you look vaguely no, you don't look familiar at all, never mind. It's unusual for people to come to such an out-of-the-way place. Yeah, I had a fly here. Can't remember how long it's been since my last guest. Who are you? Me? I don't know. What? You don't even know who you are? It's been a while since I gave it any thought. But it's what they used to call me. Oh yeah, they used to call me the Chocobo Sage. That's right. Right, that was it, the Chocobo Sage. Who would forget that? Alright, now what can I do for you? Oh, can we sell and buy stuff? Ooh. You know what, we got a ton of junk that I never got to sell. I think I'll do that off screen because I don't remember exactly what was junk and what wasn't junk, but I do remember we had junk, so. Anyways, let's see, pre-chocobo stuff? Okay, yeah, I guess we'll just mess with that stuff later. Huh. Alright, well, I guess if we... Oh! Materia! Enemy skill. Okay, well, we already had like two or three of those, but sure. I'll take an extra one. Yeah, let's just get back on board. Alright, yeah, so I guess it's just B to land. Let's see... So... Yeah, it has to be a little green patch. So there is an island. Red said there was like an island with something on it. Not talking about this, right? No, because we've... It's hard to remember where we've been and where we haven't, because now it's like a whole new perspective. That seems like a new island. Oh, that's Midgar. Wonder if we'll ever be able to get back into that city. You know, I really wanted to like explore the city because it seemed like really fun and interesting, but... But at some point the game was just like, nah, you should leave. Huh. Maybe I should talk to Red again. I'm sorry if I'm boring you and I don't know where to go, but the game just like opened up. It it was very linear for the past like 10-20 episodes, and then suddenly they're just like, yeah, you can go everywhere now. So, all right, what were you saying? Appears to be a small island near the life stream. So the life stream sometimes gushes out at the Southern Island. Remember hearing about this? Okay, Southern Island, life stream gushing out. All right, we're going south then. And by south, I mean we're going so far north that we pop out south, because video games. All right, so I guess we're just gonna keep going this way until we find a little island. I do see a island on the mini map thing. So, is it where that dot is? I'm wondering if it is. Okay, I believe we've been here before though. Can I set down here? No, can't do it on a forest. There we go. It's weird playing as just Tifa, but whatever. Yeah, have we been here? It looks a little, doesn't really look too familiar. Huh, yeah, this looks like a new area. Alright. Hey there, old man. Ain't you a beaut? Here's Medil. It's quite the hot springs town. Just the perfect place for old folks like us to live our lives. Hear that things aren't so peaceful on the outside, but here it's still nice and quiet. Oh, alright. I wonder what you can do here. Is this just... I hear like... What was that music from? I swear we heard this music before. Was it during the Chocobo race? Also, there's a tiny Chocobo. Welcome, welcome... We always welcome cash. Oh, okay. Afraid other customers have already booked it up. There's nothing left. Just kidding. Alright, alright, let's see. Ah, we got some normal items here. Man, we could, certainly buy a few tents. We don't have many. Ethers, that would be useful. You know, we have so much money, and, we don't need that many more Phoenix Sounds, but yeah, we have just like a ton of money and we've never really got a chance to spend it recently, so guess I'll just buy a few things. Alright, see ya. It's funny, there's a little chocobo. It's so cute! Alright, hey there. Gather round, gather round, this is a bargain. Got the best armor and weapons. Ooh, can we finally upgrade our stuff? Step right up, you there. Don't just stand around outside. Come on. Alright, so, we can get some weapons in here. Alright, welcome to the charity store, the store of love and courage. What can I get you? Love and courage. Sells weapons. Okay. Crystal sword. I mean, I'm pretty sure we get Cloud back at some point and this will be useful. So I'm gonna go ahead and get one. I'm just gonna assume it's gonna be useful. This looks good. That looks good. And I... Yeah, I'll stick with using Yuffie and Barret. I don't think I'm gonna use the other people. Let's see, Crystal Bangle. Ooh, this looks pretty good. I'm gonna get... I don't want to get too many. Just three? Yeah, three's good. Alright. Yeah, I might just equip this stuff off screen. You guys don't need to see that. So can you tell me what's going on? That overgrown moon's gonna fall on us, huh? This is no joke, we gotta start sucking up supplies before they're all gone. You do realize that if it crashes into the planet, like, you're just gonna die? Like, it doesn't matter if you stock up or not. Just saying.